Hello there, wormlings. Black Dragon King here. Welcome back to Let's Play Skyrim. Anyway, last time we got through Helgen Cave here to the exit. And let's get outside and see what's going on here. We do have another level to gain, so once I get out, I'll do that. Let's go for more stamina. Yeah, that'll be good. Wait, can I put that into archery yet? Yes, I can. Perfect. We're good.
Wait.
Ralof, why are you crouching? He's not even paying attention to us.
Looks like he's gone for good this time. No way to know if anyone else made it out alive. But this place is going to be swarming with Imperials soon enough. Better clear out of here.
All right.
My sister, Gerder, runs the mill in Riverwoods, just up the road. I'm sure she'd help you out.
It's probably best if we split up. Good luck. I wouldn't have made it without your help today.
Well, I know I was around here when I dropped my coin purse. I was gathering some plants for alchemy. Where is it? Ah, there it is. Still full. All right. Ralof, our money problems are no longer a problem. Yeah. Knows what it means. Because last time I checked, dragons have been gone for hundreds of years. Don't know where they've been all these years. But anyway, you want to go to Riverwood? Go right ahead. I'm gonna go see if I can find my camp. See if I can recover any of my gear. If it hasn't been raided yet. And I'll meet you there. Just gotta remember where it was. Get some flowers on the way through, why not? And a butterfly.
See that ruin up there? Bleak Falls Barrow. I never understood how my sister could stand living in the shadow of that place. I guess you get used to it.
I remember seeing that when I set up camp, so if I remember correctly, camp was this way. Whoa! Damn wolves. And we got a fox belt too. Why not? Ah, here's my camp. I hear you. Hmm. didn't get to all my stuff yet. Good thing.
Now ain't this a sound? I'll try and make this quick.
Where's the third one? Killed an innocent bunny. How dare they? I know there's a third one around here somewhere.
No sign of you. Hello there, fellow traveler.
Well then.
An itinerant minstrel and wandering wastrel at your service. The life of...
Ah.
Afraid not. But if you're serious about sharpening that tongue, you might try the Bard's College in solitude.
Well, we didn't have to take out the last bandit because this traveling bard did. We will take the bandit's gear, though. And we picked up a treasure spell, or treasure map. Now that's Riverwood there on the map. An X indicates that large tree trunk. And inside the tree trunk is another X. So, basically, with a bunch of, there's a bunch of treasure maps around that you can pick up randomly. Mostly from bandits and whatnot. But, when you look at the map, it triggers a treasure loot crate to be spawned there. And then you can go pick it up once you figure out the location. And we will be power leveling soon, but until we get there, I want to activate the Thief Stone because I want to quickly level my sneak and archery while we're working here. I'm gonna save real quick. That way, in case anything goes wrong, if the game crashes out on me or whatnot, I don't lose my progress. Save often, viewers. Because even without mods, this game still crashes on occasion on console, so be wary of that. Anyway, we want to come up here to Ember Shard Mine. Stuff here, but there's also some bandits we can kill. Sorry, babe. You're cute, but you don't go after me like that. And if you haven't guessed, viewers, I did turn the music back on. Because the music is soothing. It may take away a little bit of the immersion, but, you know, it's still good. Anyway, let's check out Ember Shard. Gain another level real quick, more stamina. Stamina is always good. Can't level anything up at the moment, but we'll get there. take a few torches since I got the Darkness Falls immersion thing. It's gonna be dark outside at night, so I'm gonna need light to travel with. And they're gonna need to hide that rock trap a lot better if they wanna catch me in it. Be quiet, viewers. We have another. One. How dare you move? Basically wasting arrow. Fucker. But we got him. How's my carry weight doing? Yeah, we still got plenty of breathing room for carry weight. Let's loot these boys. Where's that arrow? There it is. Got our other tool that we need, the pickaxe. And let's start mining some iron. If I remember correctly, there's... seven, eight, I think, in this mine. Eight ore veins. One there. One over here. And then the rest are later on. Mushrooms, coin purse. We don't need to read the journal. Kind of easy to tell what happened to that guy. He just talks about it in his journal. It's in here. Apples. Crouch and sneak. Activate the lever. Ready to shoot.
Thought we had a guard posted outside. We did. Right. What's that?
With those guys. Grab the torches on the way back through. Use them outside later. We got another enemy to deal with around here. It's a Khajiit this time. Alright. Got him dealt with. Third ore vein is right here. More mushrooms to collect. Now that bandit behind us that we just shot has the key to both of these gates, but I want to unlock them with picks to level my lock picking there. There we go. Now that's 25. I can spend another point on that to get apprentice locks. There we go. Now we can loot this guy. See, he had the key. Hail, key, gold, armor, axe. The apples. Ooh, berries. Take all that. Take the potion. See what's in here. Leather, imperial, gold, poison, and iron gauntlets. Nothing too good, too fancy, but it's money. The apples. Apples. Apples are good. Apples are delicious. I love apples. Do you like apples, viewers? These torches. Fourth iron vein is right here, right to the right of the cells there. And the fifth one is right here. Another reason why to take torches, viewers, is it darkens the place and makes you harder to see. So if you're sneaking and enemies are searching for you, if it's dark, they'll have a harder time seeing you. Unless they're like a Khajiit and they have night vision, then they might see you better, but you still have a good chance to stay hidden if you are in the darkness. We have more bandits. We have three more in this large cavern here. One down here. One way over there. Got one more, if I can reach him. You see him sitting there, viewers. Got him. It might be a her. I can't tell from this distance. But that can't describe the sound, but it's kind of like a cheery victory sound, sort of. When you hear that sound, it means the dungeon's been cleared of enemies. You can only hear it if you got the music volume turned on, but I don't know if you can hear it on my game, but I heard it. All right, while we're here, get some more stamina. Sneaking, I can make that better. More archery, I think we're good for levels right now. Mushrooms. Number six, or vein, here underneath. I don't know where every ore vein in every dungeon is, but I know a lot of them. The ones I know about, I'll let you know. If I miss any viewers, let me know. I don't think there was any up this side here. I'll just double check. No. We're good. We'll loot her when we get over there. Her, him. Still can't tell. But back here we got some stuff to grab out of the sacks, and we got a chest back here. And barrels. Ugh, hate cabbage. You like cabbage, viewers? I can't stand it. Ironic, because I'm Irish. Well, part Irish. The other part of me is German. I don't want the flower. Put that back. Put that back! Thank you. Hurts, since it's alchemy ingredient. Potions. Ooh, gemstones and gold. Apples. And here's the chest over here. Got some good stuff in there. And lastly, the torch. Got more stuff over here to check through. Dagger, that's money. Finally, check out this bandit here. Yeah, it was a her. You can tell because she's got better gear than normal. Since I have the Deadly Wenches mod. A lot of people say modding is cheating, but not when that modding is making the game harder for you. Get this. Nope. If you're good enough, you can get that. Oh, wait, I have the high jump. Maybe I can step in here. Nope. Maybe from that other ledge over there. I'll get it. The high jump is helpful, because sometimes you get stuck in places and the high jump allows you to get out of those places. What the? I don't know what that was, but get to the edge here. I'll get it when I jump off. But we got a chest here that we can pick. Garnet, gold, iron, steel, circlet, boots, and a dagger. Why not? Here's number 7, ore vein, on this ledge here. Before we get that hanging moss, let's get these torches. Give this a shot. Yeah! Got it! Good. And we're done in here. Let's get my sword again. Armor, shield, weaponry. And over here in this corner is the last of the ore veins inside the mine here. And we're good. So we should have 26 iron ore. 24 from the veins that we got and the 2 that I picked up off of that table. Yep, we're good. Let's head out now. I do have the alternate start mod now, by the way, viewers, so at some point I might showcase some of those starts on new characters if I decide. Not just yet, though. I'm gonna actually get somewhere with this character first. But if you come over here, there's one last iron vein here. So that totals 9. I don't really count it with part of the Ember Shard ore veins because it's not inside the mine, but it's there to give you an extra 3 iron ore. A lot of times there's wolves over here. They don't seem to be here this time. So, move on. On here, we got some slaughterfish eggs. Cross over the river here, we got some Nirn root. Now, while we're over here, remember that treasure map, viewers? That location is right up here. This fallen tree, because Riverwood's right over there. So in this tree, besides some mushrooms that we can pick off the side of it, we have our treasure loot. Corundum, garnet, gold, soul gem, and a copper circlet. Not too shabby, most of that's good money. Not that we're strapped for cash, but dead bunny floating down the river. Oh well.
What is it, woman? Spend drunk on the job
again? Anyway, let's come over here.
Ralof, what are you doing here?
And we meet up with Ralof again. And I want to talk to this guy too.
Did I see you talking?
No, I don't want to kiss him. Enough, too close. No.
For a Nord village,
bring me better at archery first. Max that out. And what's your problem with Sven?
He's a bard. Occasionally, he finds time to do his job here at the mill. Thinks his ballads and sonnets are going to convince Camilla Valerius to marry him. As if she would say yes. An intelligent, beautiful woman like her wouldn't fall for that nonsense. I hope.
You're right. When have words ever inspired feelings of love?
I don't need your jokes right now. But maybe you have a point. Maybe Camilla needs some help seeing Sven for what he is. Could you give her this letter and say it's from Sven? I think I've matched that Nord's lack of cleverness perfectly.
The funny thing is, Feindahl and Sven are both vying for Camilla's feelings. Yet,
I can't remember when I last slept.
If you do everything that is needed for her, you can end up being the one that marries her.
Imperials ambushed us outside Darkwater Crossing.
Take her out from like they knew underneath exactly both of them.
That was 2 days ago now. We stopped in Helgen this morning, and I thought it was all over. Had us lined up to the headsman's block and ready to start chopping.
The cowards.
They wouldn't dare give Ulfric a fair trial. Treason for fighting for your own people. All of Skyrim would have seen the truth then. But then, out of nowhere, a dragon attacked.
You don't mean a real live?
I can hardly believe it myself. And I was there. As strange as it sounds, we'd be dead if not for that dragon. In the confusion, we managed to slip away. Are we really the first to make it to Riverwood?
Nobody else has come up the South Road today, as far as I know.
Good. Maybe we can lay up for a while. I hate to put your family in danger, Gerda, but...
Nonsense. You and your friend are welcome to stay here as long as you need to. Let me worry about the Imperials. Any friend of Ralof's is a friend of mine. Here's the key to the house. Stay as long as you like. If there is anything else you need, just let me know.
Alright. Let's see what you got. Mead, definitely. Alchemy, sure, sure. Take all that. Take that, take that, take that. And you can keep that crap.
There is something you could do for me. For all of us here.
Okay.
Jarl needs to know if there's a dragon on the loose. Riverwood is defenseless. We need to get word.
Kind of. You don't even have a wall.
To send whatever troops he can. If you'll do that for me, I'll be in your debt.
Thanks.
All right,
sister.
You got it.
I knew we could count on you.
I ought to get back to work before I missed, but did anyone else escape? Did Ulfric?
Don't worry. I'm sure he made it out. It'll take more than a dragon to stop Ulfric Stormcloak. I'll let them into the house and, you know, show them where everything is.
Help them drink up our mead, you mean?
Yeah, well, luck, sounds a good, like a good later. Plan to me.
Don't
drink the mead sounds
that.
Good.
I know how to lay low. I told you my sister would help us out. Next Imperial
All
I
right.
see is dead.
Really think I should join up with Ulfric Stormcloak?
Damn right. Just like all true sons of Skyrim should. You should come to Windhelm with me and join the fight to free Skyrim. You've seen the true face of the Empire here today. If anyone will know what the coming of the dragon
is... Yeah, and you
is,
just say what you said earlier. Yeah, I know. Okay. Let's save again.
Yes.
And we got some other stuff to do here. We got... stuff to sell. Oh, right. We want to talk to Sven.
What? Faendal thinks he can woo Camilla Valerius away from
me. Faendal wanted me to deliver this letter to Camilla. Say it was from you.
What is this? The elf playing a treachery? Shocking. As if I would write this dribble. How about we play a bit of a turnabout with Faendal? Here. I had to use simple words, but this letter should convince Camilla it's from him.
And this is why you can...
You
are the one who gets Camilla and not either one of these fools. They're both jealous idiots trying to...
If you keep on like this, everyone in town will think you're crazy.
Whatever
manipulate Camilla into not being the other one. Anyway. We want to... level up first. More stamina. And we want to... can't sell anything yet. Or not sell... oh, we can add perks. Archery. Eagle Eye and Critical Shot.
Well, then you'll believe me.
Now, we want to grab our stuff out of the portable hole here. That's a lot of money we can get.
Iron or steel is what you... Blades...
What have you got for sale?
Pretty much anything to suit your needs.
Yeah, I'll buy all your supplies there. And your arrows. Don't ask why I always buy arrows, viewers. I just do. Anyway, sell that. Both of them. Both of those. One dagger, one sword. Both of those. Both of those. One, one. Both, one. And at this point, we've already drained him dry. Doesn't take much to drain him. Our speechcraft leveled up like crazy. Well, let's put a few points into that, shall we? You want to get merchant, definitely. Investor. Yeah, I think we're good. Talk to him again and invest in his business.
Well, I won't turn down your money. You have my thanks, friend.
Good reason to invest. Not only do they get a little bit more gold every time, but they always, but because of it, every time you talk to them afterward, once they refresh their stock, they will have a better stock of equipment. Yeah, we'll sell three of them now. I'm only missing out on one gold.
Right.
Whatever.
See you around.
Oh, right. There's something I want to do at a tanning rack. Hey, I need to use this. Move. I want to get this. Traveler's cloak. Travel, because cloaks and capes are cool. You know this. Down at the bottom. Traveler's cloak. And it matches well with the dragon bone that I got.
Hey there.
Well, not the bone itself, but the fur underneath. It matches perfectly. So. And you'll be getting, I'll be getting the level up music quite a lot for a good amount of time. Anyway.
You're kind of fuzzy. What's wrong with you?
One more thing that I want to do before we end this video, because I'm getting close to my time here.
Come on in. We got warm food.
I'm in here.
And warm beds.
This is an ode to Skyrim's
staunch. Who are you?
Can I help you? I'm Mandin Hlalu, representative of the great House Hlalu of Morrowind. I'm here in Skyrim on urgent business. I doubt it.
Can you help with?
Thank you for the offer. The kind of help I need. I need someone with power beyond measure.
Would the Dragonborn suffice?
That it would. In fact, I've been trying to get in touch with you, but it seems my letters never found their mark. Couriers these days. Back to business. As neighbors, Skyrim and Morrowind share more than a border. Our fates are intertwined. We must look out for one another.
As such, I suppose.
When a famous criminal from Morrowind was spotted in Skyrim, I was dispatched by House Hlalu to find him. However, he is too deadly for me to face alone. I need a hero's help.
This hero comes with a fee.
And a fee this hero shall have. Does 1,000 septims pique your interest?
I'm a really, really good hero.
And quite the haggler as well. 2,000 septims. That's all I have to offer.
That's better.
Excellent.
We don't want to be greedy to an arrangement.
I tracked the criminal to a village southwest of here called Little Vivek. But after that, the trail went cold. However, you may have better luck.
You have any information about the criminal?
Not only is he a fearsome combatant, but he is silver-tongued. If he begs for his life, do not believe a word he says.
What will you do in the meantime?
I will continue my investigation elsewhere. I have another lead I'd like to explore. I'll be sure to contact you if it bears fruit.
Well, I better get started.
Wait, before you go, take this ring. The criminal is known to wield enchanted blades, and this may protect you from them.
Oh.
Happy hunting, Dragonborn. And
well, thank you. Thanks.
You are doing both Morrowind and Skyrim a great service.
If it didn't figure, if you don't, if you didn't figure it out, that's a mod for a new quest line that I got. But basically, where is it? There we go. Once you use it, once you get to him, that ring has fire resistance, so it's a good thing to have against that guy.
Goodbye, sir.
Need something?
Which one's the one that I wanted?
Hi there.
It doesn't matter, I guess. Marora, my daughter, finally found you. Made a good decision coming to Riverwood. You listened.
Is there
something
I can do for you? Have you seen that shrine of Azura?
If we can get rumors.
They say, people say there's someone in Riften that can change your face.
Okay.
Make you look completely different.
Oh.
Do you believe that?
Anyway, I am about all out of time for this episode, viewers, so for next time, I will be power leveled at least up to where I want to be. Or at least close to it. So. And I'll have all my excess equipment sold that I don't care about or that I don't want to keep. And we'll be ready to hit up the next mission here. Which we gotta talk to a few people around town still, so. But anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. It's been fun playing with you guys, and I'll catch you all in the next one. Peace out, Wormlings.